This video is for Jeffrey. Don't make any stupid mistake here. Again. So e power negative 18x is equal to 1 plus something divided by 1 factorial plus something squared divided by 2 factorial. Until x squared only, so the rest we just use dot dot dot. And then just fill in the blank. And then put ascending power, check once again, this is ascending power, and then we finish part A. Let's focus on part B. They give us that coefficient of x squared term of a sum expansion is, that means equal negative 38. So that's why we are working on this item expressed in terms of n here. Then we can form an equation with n, then we can solve it finally. Therefore, we consider the expansion. This is part A answer. Well, another part, we are going to use binomial theorem to expand it. We have 1 power of n and then plus. By the binomial theorem, we have nc1, 1 power of n minus 1, and then 4x power of 1. The next term is nc2, 1 power of n minus 2, and then 4x power of 2. So on and so on. But we just focus on x power of 2, so we can ignore the rest. nc1, that means n, so this is positive 4n times of x. And then nc2, that means n times the next n minus 1, and then divide by 2 factorial, that means 2. And then times 16x squared here. So finally, we tidy up both brackets, then we can focus on the coefficient of x squared. In order to get x squared from the first term in the first bracket, 1, need to multiply something x squared, so need to multiply this term in order to create x squared. Similar reason, negative 18x from the first bracket, need to multiply positive 4nx in order to get x squared. 162x squared, need to multiply constant in order to keep the power of x become 2. And all the terms behind x power 3 times anything will become x power 3 or even higher power, so we just negate it. Therefore, we can write the conclusion. 1 need to times this term. We don't need to write down x squared because we talk about coefficient, just the number part. So 1 times 8n times n minus 1. And then negative 18. We need to times the number here, 4n. Positive 162. We need to times the constant. That means positive 1 here. It's equal to negative 38. We get the equation with n be the only unknown. Then the rest, we just need to handle this quadratic equation. Both sides divided by 8. So we have n minus 5 bracket square equals 0. N is equal to 5, which is our repeated roots.